Type 1 diabetes and physical activity. What school staff should know? Like all kids, students with type 1 diabetes need to be active every day to maintain a healthy heart and strong muscles and bones. They should be able to participate fully in gym classes and in any team or individual sports they choose, with a little more planning and care. This may involve extra blood sugar checks or a change in insulin or food. Some students may disconnect their pump temporarily or lower their background insulin for a short time. Physical activity usually lowers blood sugar, so students always need their glucose meter and emergency kit nearby. Some students will need an extra snack before starting an activity, especially if their blood sugar is in the target range or is going low. The amount of food depends on the student and the type of activity. The student's care plan will have these details. Although physical activity usually lowers blood sugar, some activities may cause it to rise, especially if they involve sprinting. The high is usually short-lived, and after the activity, blood sugar will drop on its own, sometimes quickly. It's important to always watch for symptoms of low blood sugar during and after activity. A lack of physical activity without proper planning can also lead to high blood sugar. If students have less activity because they're inside on a rainy day, for example, blood sugars may be higher than usual. There are only two reasons to delay or limit physical activity for a student with diabetes. First, when they have low blood sugar. This must be treated before starting the activity. Second, when a student's blood sugar is very high and when a urine or blood test shows that they have ketones. This can be a sign of illness. A student's care plan will have more information about what to do before physical activity. Understanding how physical activity affects blood sugar can help keep kids with type 1 diabetes safe at school.